a 20s anniversary two-step medley there from Harry Davidson. Until midnight, you're with Alex Hehr, and thanks for the memory on the great Southern Sounds of Melbourne, Southern FM 88.3. Don't forget, if you want to give us a telephone call, our number is 9556 4466. 9556 4466. We'd love to talk to you. 9:30 in Melbourne.
Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me.
On Thanks for the Memory, and we present Crosby Corner.
Crowns the blue of her eyes like a halo tenderly.
And welcome to another edition of Crosby Corner. And leading off in this particular Crosby Corner, the song Never in a Million Years. Bing Crosby with the Jimmy Dorsey Orchestra, from the Fox film Wake Up and Live. The song written by Mac Gordon and Harry Revel, and they recorded this one in Los Angeles on the 28th of February, 1937. Never in a Million Years.
Never in a million years could there be another you. I would shed a million tears if ever we were through. Never in a million moons could you ever be surpassed. And darling, for a million Junes, this love of ours will last. There would be no world for me if ever we would part. Where I go, your name will be right on the tip of my heart. For only once in every lifetime, someone just like you appears. Is there any greater glory, any greater thrill? No, never in a million years. We would part. Where I go, your name will be right on the tip of my heart. For only once in every lifetime, someone just like you appears. Is there any greater glory, any greater thrill? No, never in a million years. Never in a million years.
And of course the song was sung by Alice Faye in the film Wake Up and Live, and that was Bing's interpretation of Never in a Million Years. Well, now here's a duet with Bing and Patty Andrews with the Vic Schoen Orchestra. The song If I Were a Bell was written by Frank Lesser, and it was sung originally by Isabel Bigley in his show Guys and Dolls, which of course was based on the story by Damon Runyon. They recorded If I Were a Bell in Los Angeles on the 7th of September 1950.
Ask me how do I feel? Ask me now that we're cozy and clinging. Well, sir, all I can say is if I were a bell, I'd be ringing. From the moment we kissed tonight, that's the way I've just got to behave. If I were a lamp, I'd light. Or if I were a banner, I'd wave.
Ask me how do I feel, a little me with my quiet upbringing.
Oh, this is classy tomato.
What else? Well, sir, all I can say is if I were a gate, I'd be swinging.
Now you're back with the group. And if I were a watch, I'd start popping my spring.
Heaven, you're a fling.
Or if I were a bell, I'd go ding dong, ding dong, ding.
Ask me how do I feel from this chemistry lesson I'm learning.
Hey, kid, let's get this out of the classroom, huh?
Oh, well, all I can say is if I were a bridge, I'd be burning.
Desperate.
Well, I knew my morale would crack.
Crack?
Fracture.
From the wonderful way you looked.
Boy.
If I were a duck, I'd quack. And if I were a goose, I'd be cooked. Ask me how do I feel. Ask me now that we're finally caressing.
Okay, how do you feel?
Tune in at 6. Mm. Pal, if I were a salad, I know I'd be splashing my dressing.
Bing, that's awful.
Duncan Hines will hate me.
Or if I were a season, I'd surely be spring.
Oh, this is a beautiful thing.
Or
if I were a bell, I'd go ding dong, ding dong, ding. If I were a watch, I'd start popping my spring, having my fling. Or if I were a bell, I'd go ding-a-dong, ding-a-dong.
Bing Crosby there with Patty Andrews, and If I Were a Bell from Guys and Dolls, bringing to a close tonight's edition of Crosby Corner.
Where the blue of the night meets the gold of the day, someone waits for me.
Wherever you go, there's radio. Yes, radio is here to stay. You can depend upon a great show wherever you go on radio. Wherever you go, there's radio. This radio is here to stay. Whether home or in your car, no matter where you are, there's radio night and day. Wherever you go, there's radio, and radio is here to stay.
21 minutes to 10. Think of your lungs as a balloon. Now, think of this balloon trapped in a vise. This is how it feels to have an asthma attack. Each year, over 750 Australians die from these attacks. The Asthma Foundation finances research and education aimed to save these lives with no government funding. An envelope will soon arrive in your letterbox. Please give generously and help save the lives asthma keeps taking away.
Now, request for Margaret at Noble Park. Thank you for being patient, Margaret.
I'm sure you'll enjoy this particular tune, as will I, and I know the rest of our listeners will. And don't forget that our number here is 955-644-66, if you'd like a request played. All you have to do is ring me at the station, or ring me during the week and leave a message, or write to Alex Hehr, Southern FM, 88.3, and it's PO Box 188, Moorabbin, 3189. We'll be happy to play a request for you down the track. Now, for Margaret, here's the Studio 2 Concert Orchestra and a 1952 tune written by Ronald Binge, Elizabethan Serenade. I hope you enjoy it.
Reaching into your community, the great southern sounds of Melbourne, 88.3 Southern FM.
Oh, ordinary people. We never make any fuss. We're the easygoing kind. If you look around, you'll find that there's a million like us. We're always on the outside, on the outside, always looking in. We never know how fortunes are made, for the sun when it shines finds us still in the shade. We're always on the ebb tide, but we'll keep on trying till we win. For we know someday we're gonna be on the inside, instead of outside, always looking in.
This is the BBC Light Program.
This is your station for music, for news and sports. Now we must pause for a moment, our call letters to report. This is radio station
88.3 Southern FM.
Your station for music and news and sports.
Where can you go, Ed Sailing? Ah! Rock climbing! Whitewater rafting! Flying! Ah!
Making friends. You can do all this in the Scouts, if you dare.
If you're a girl or guy between 6 and 26, Scouts is for you. To join Victoria's largest youth movement, call 9 349 2500.
And be prepared for adventure!
Hello, this is Steve Price with a reminder every Tuesday, 8 till 10pm. It's all happening, solid gold hits, 60s and 70s on the great southern sounds of Melbourne, 88.3 Southern FM.
Ah yes, thank you very much Steve, my good buddy, Steve Price on a Tuesday between 8 and 10. We heard before Giraldo's orchestra there with On the Outside Looking In from 1939, and Jack Harris's orchestra with Sam Brown on vocals, and When the Organ Played, Oh Promise Me. Pretty song, wasn't it? Coming up to 9 minutes to 10 at 10 o'clock, Al Jolson, His Life and His Times.
Until midnight, you're on Thanks for the Memory from Southern FM, 88.3.
Thank you. wasn't it? Yesterday's Gardenias, Charlie Spivak and his orchestra, with the vocal by Gary Stevens, written in 1942 by Dick Robertson, Nelson Canaan and Sammy Measles, Meisels, M-Y-S-E-L-S. It's 5:30 to 10 now with 88.3 Southern FM, and I think we'll have this. Until midnight, you're with Thanks for the Memory with Alex Hehr on 88.3 Southern FM. And let's have some music from Winnie Atwell, shall we? Yes, Winnie Atwell there, and a crazy little thing called Crazy Words and Crazy Tune. 2:30 to 10, 88.3, 10 o'clock, our special with a tribute to Al Jolson. Thank you.
On 88.3 Southern FM, it's a minute before 10 o'clock, and the special every week at this time is brought to you by our very good friends at Quality Records Plus. No matter what your taste in music, you'll find it at Quality Records Plus. Yes, Melbourne's finest range of new and used LPs and CDs featuring easy listening, nostalgia, jazz, classical and show music is at Quality Records Plus, 263 Glenferrie Road, Malvern. Phone 500-9902. Call in and spend some time browsing. Mention Southern FM and receive a special discount. Quality Records Plus are proud sponsors of 88.3 Southern FM. If you haven't got down there yet, do yourself a favour. They have wonderful vinyl, and really the prices have got to be seen to be believed. They are so good. And of course, mention Southern FM and you get that extra special discount. Quality Records Plus in Malvern. Just after 10 o'clock in Melbourne, 88.3, it's time for the special. Tomorrow, the 23rd of October, marks the 45th anniversary of the death of Al Jolson, who died in 1950. I thought it was appropriate that I write a program dealing with the life and the times of Al Jolson, and of course, you can't fit that all into a half an hour. So we've only touched on some of the highlights, these recordings and films, play some of the music that you perhaps weren't aware Jolie recorded, particularly in the early part of his life, and some of the versions of it a little bit different to what you normally hear. So I hope you enjoy the 10 o'clock special, The Life and Times of Al Jolson.
Let me sing a funny song with crazy words that roll along. And if my song can start you laughing, I'm happy, so happy.
He was billed as the world's greatest entertainer. From the moment he first walked on stage until the day he died, Al Jolson considered the world his stage, and he played to his audience the only way he knew, with every ounce of energy he could muster and the catch cry, "You ain't heard nothing yet."
A low-down blues to lift you out of your seat. And if my song can reach your shoes and start you tapping your feet, I'm happy.
In the next 30 minutes or so, we'll take a brief look at the life and times of Al Jolson. Such a life cannot be encapsulated in that short space of time, so we'll concentrate on the highlights and some of the musical numbers which made him famous. He was born Asa Jolson in Lithuania about May 26, 1886, the exact date lost in the mists of time, to Rabbi Moshe Jolson and his wife Naomi. In 1890, Rabbi Jolson left their homeland and sailed for the USA, settling originally in New York City. 4 years later, the rest of the family left their home and sailed from Liverpool on the steamer Umbria and arrived at Ellis Island on the 9th of April, 1894. From New York, they took the train to Washington, D.C., and their new home, which was above Barnes's Flower and Feed Store at 208 4½ Street in the southwest corner of the city. Jolson's career probably started in the summer of 1896 when he and his brother Harry sang songs for nickels and dimes on street corners. It was those informal performances that gave him his first taste of applause and the indescribable thrill of knowing he had pleased his listeners. Using the funds thrown at them for singing, both Harry and Al began attending the live theatres in the city where the top New York attractions played on tour. In 1900, Al joined the Victoria Burlesquers while they played in Washington, and soon after the company left for Providence, and with them went Al Jolson. Al's first appearance in a legit Broadway show was in September 1911 in La Belle Paris, singing but one song. In November that same year, he went into Vera Violetta, and his musical output increased 100% to two songs. These were Rum Tum Tiddle and the George M. Cohan composition, That Haunting Melody. Jolson's recording career is alleged to have commenced in 1910 with rumours of a session on February 9th of that year with the Edison Company. Come Along Mandy and that mesmerising Mendelssohn tune were supposed to have been recorded with the Edison Orchestra. However, no evidence has ever been cited, nor have any masters or tests come to light over the years. Jolson made his first extant records for the Victor Talking Machine Company in 1911, recording the two songs he sang in Vera Violetta in addition to Asleep in the Deep. This session was on December 22, 1911. In all, he cut 13 sides for Victor, of which 10 were released. In 1913, Jolson made it to a new career pinnacle when, for the first time, he received sole top billing in a revised edition of The Honeymoon Express, which opened at the New York Winter Garden Theatre on Monday, April 28th. To complement his more exalted status, Jolson upgraded from Victor to a contract with the Columbia Graphophone Company, and the first session transpired on June 4th.
My window every morn, I can hear a great big horn. In the backyard, there they are. They want money when they play. I give them more to go away. They all play something new. They play until they're blue. And when you think they're through, they sing a line or two. La 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 la, that pretty melody. La 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 la, like the bird is in the tree. La 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 la, won't sing this song with me. La 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 la, la 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 la. That's a pretty melody. Like the bird is in the tree. La 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 la, won't you sing a song with me? La 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 la. Oh, that music is so grand, from the little German band. Something sour is in his flute, the bass horn feller is the best. He can almost drown the rest. They all stand in a ring, they play the same old thing. The leader pulls a string, they drop their horns and sing. La 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 la, that pretty melody. La 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 la, like the bird is in the tree. La 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 la, won't sing this song with me. La 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 la, la 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 la. That's a pretty melody. La la la, like the bird is in the tree. La 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 la, won't you sing this song with me? La 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 la, la 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 la. Now boys, we got that all wrong. We should sing it like South's band sings it, because we're all in that condition and it would come very easy for us to do so. Now we'll take it very staccato. Of course, you boys don't know what staccato is because it's a high-term musical phrase that I learned while in the Conservatory of Music in Pittsburgh. Are you ready? Let her go. La 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 la, that's a pretty melody. La 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 la, like the bird is in the tree. La 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 la, won't you sing this song with me? La 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 la, la 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 la. That's a shiner melody. La 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 la, like the powders in the bush. La 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 la, what think you need for Rooney? La 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 la, la 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 la.
On an evening I heard a a hula made on play. Yanko hula hicky doola, yanko hula hicky doo. Down Hawaiian way, by the moonlight bay. But when I linger a while, see, throw my heart away. Yanko hula hicky doola, yanko hula hicky doo. Oh, I don't care if you love the ladies far and near. You'd forget about them all if you should hear. Yako hula hiki chula, yako hula hiki chula. I'm coming back to you, my hula. If I can see that my key you'll play for me, and once again you'll sway my heart away with your yakahula, yakahula loo. I'm coming back to you, my hula loo. Across the sea, at Waikiki, I want to play for me. And once again, you'll sway my heart away with your yakahula.
Jolson was to remain with Columbia for a full decade, and during that time he was one of the most successful and prolific recording artists of the era. His Columbia output totaled some 75 songs. This may not seem a lot in 10 years, but it was twice that of his output for Decca in the 1940s. In 1924, Jolson switched from the Victor label to Brunswick, and on February 24th, whilst playing in Chicago on tour with Bombo, he walked into the Brunswick studios and cut four sides with the Isham Jones Orchestra. They were I'm Going South, Never Again, The One I Love Belongs to Somebody Else, and this one.
When the wintry winds are blowing and the snow is starting in the fall, then my eyes turn westward, knowing that's the place that I love best of all. California, I've been blue since I've been away from you. I can't wait till I get going. Even now I'm starting in the call. Oh, California, here I come, right back where I started from, where bowers of flowers bloom in the sun. Each morning, that dawning bird is singing, everything a sun kiss, kiss, said, don't be late. That's why I can hardly wait. Open up your golden gate, California, here I come. Thank you. a bower of flowers bloom in the sun. Each morning at dawning, birdies sing and everything undone. Kiss, miss, said, don't be late. That's why I can hardly wait. Open up your golden gate, California, here I come.
Jolson's role in The Jazz Singer is legendary. However, myths still cloud the truth about his signing the contract with Warner Brothers. George Jeschel was originally offered the part, and rather than refusing outright, he wanted $10,000 inducement before he would leave New York. Jack Warner used Jeschel's difficult attitude to approach Jolie. Warner already knew that Al wanted the role. There is also the myth that Al took all or part of his salary in Warner stock. Al was paid $75,000 for The Jazz Singer, one-third advance in cash, and the remainder in installments of $6,250 per week. The Warners did not offer him any stock, and he did not put up any money to help finance the picture, as Jeschel often claimed. The Jazz Singer premiered at the Warner Theatre in New York on October the 6th, 1927.
Wait a minute. You ain't heard nothing yet. Wait a minute, I tell you. You ain't heard nothing.
Blue jays, they say, all of them gone. Nothing but blue skies from now on.
You like that, Mama?
Yeah. I'm glad of it. I'd rather please you than anybody I know of.
Mama, darling, if I'm a success in this show,
well, we're going to move from here.
Oh, yes, we're going to move up in the Bronx. A lot of nice green grass up there and a whole lot of people you know. There's the Ginsbergs, the Guttenbergs, and the Goldbergs. Oh, a whole lot of birds. I don't know them all. And I'm going to buy you a nice black silk dress, Mama. You see, Mrs. Friedman, the butcher's wife, she'll be jealous of you.
Oh, no.
Yes, she will. You see if she isn't. And I'm going to get you a nice pink dress that'll go with your brown eyes.
What
do you mean, no? Who is telling you? What do you mean, no? Yes, you'll wear pink or else. Or else you'll wear pink. And, darling, Mama, listen, I'm going to sing this like I will if I go on the stage, you know, with this show. I'm going to sing it jazzy. Now, get this.
Blue sky, smiling at me, me. Nothing but little blue sky, do I see? Do. Blue bird, singing a song. Nothing but little blue bird, all day long. You like that slap, don't you?
Jolson concluded his recording career with Brunswick Records in a session in New York City on the 20th of December, 1932. He was accompanied by the Guy Lombardo Orchestra.
Life is not a highway strewn with flowers. Still it holds a goodly share of bliss. When the sun gives way to April showers, here's a thought that we should never miss. Though April showers may come your way, they bring the flowers that bloom in May. And if it's raining, have no regrets, because it is raining, rain, you know, it's raining violets. And where you see clouds upon the hills, you soon will see crowds of a daffodil. So keep on looking for a bluebird and listening for its song. Whenever April showers come along. Though April showers may come your way, they bring the flowers that bloom in May.
And if it's rainy, if it's rainy, have no regret, because it isn't raining rain, you know. It's raining violet. And where you see clouds on the hills, look, they're not clouds, no, no. They're crowds of daffodils. So keep on looking for a bluebird and listening for its song. Whenever April showers come,
all through the 1930s and 40s, Jolson starred on radio in his own series of broadcasts, The Kraft Music Hall, Shell Chateau, and Café Trocadero. In addition to his own programs, he guested on shows with Bob Hope, Jack Benny, Jimmy Durante, Burns and Allen, and of course his old sparring friend, Bing Crosby. In 1944, Columbia Pictures announced it was to make a film of Al's life. It was given the original working title of Minstrel Boy. This was changed to the Jolson story, and casting commenced in late 1944. Naturally, Al wanted to play himself. However, the producers had already decided upon a 31-year-old Larry Parks to play the star. Parks was a graduate of the Federal Theatre Project and had appeared in a handful of Columbia B pictures in the previous 2 years. Jolson finally accepted that Parks would play the role, and the two worked together for hours until every nuance was perfected. Jolson himself spent weeks in the studio re-recording all his old hits with lush, updated arrangements.
Yesterday I heard a lover sigh, goodbye, on your mind. 7 times he got aboard his train, and 7 times he hurried back to kiss his love again and tell her tootsie goodbye. Tootsie, don't cry. The choo-choo train that takes me away from you, no words can tell how sad it makes me. Kiss me, tootie, and then do it over again. Watch for the mail, I'll never fail. You don't get a letter, then you'll know I'm in jail. Tootsie, don't cry. Tootsie, goodbye. The stars are gonna twinkle and shine. How they'll shine this evening, about a quarter to nine. My loving arms are gonna tenderly twine around you, around a quarter to nine.
He's the Latin from Manhattan, I can tell by her manana. She's the Latin from Manhattan, but not Havana. Though she does the rumba for us, and she calls herself Dolores. She was in the Broadway chorus, known as Susie Donahue.
I found my love in Avalon, beside the bay. And I left my love in Avalon, and I sailed away.
Yeah, right back where I started from, where bowers of flowers bloom in the spring. Each morning at dawning, birdies sing, and everything a sun kiss missed. Don't be later, that's why I can hardly wait. Come on, come on, open up, open up, open up that golden gate. California, here I
The sequel to the Jolson story was Jolson Sings Again, and once again Larry Parks in the lead, and it went into production in mid-1948. Al went into the studios on August 17th to begin work on the soundtrack. These arrangements seemed clearer, stronger, and more vibrant than those used in the Jolson story. Jolson Sings Again opened at Lowe's State Theatre in New York on Wednesday, August 17th, 1949.
Oh, I'm just wild about Harry. Harry's wild about me. The heavenly blisses of his kisses fill me with ecstasy. He's sweet just like chocolate candy and like honey from the bee. Oh, I'm just wild about Harry. Harry's wild about, I can't live without. Harry's wild about me. I'm just wild about Harry. Harry's wild about me. The heavenly blizzard of his kisses fill me with ecstasy. He's sweet just like chocolate candy, and he's like honey from the bee.
The honey bee.
Oh, I'm just wild about Harry. Harry's wild about, I can't live without. Harry's wild about me.
I'm just wild about Harry, and Harry's wild about me. The heavenly blisses of his kisses fill me with ecstasy.
He's sweet just like chocolate candy, and like honey from the bee.
The honey bee.
Oh, I'm just wild about
Harry.
Harry's wild about, I can't live without Harry. Wild about me.
In June 1950, U.S. ground forces entered the Korean conflict. Jolson immediately wired Secretary of Defense Louis Johnson, volunteering to entertain the troops. On September 27, 1950, Al returned from Korea in the company of songwriter Harry Axt. On Monday, October 23rd, they boarded a plane for San Francisco and checked into the St. Francis. After eating dinner at Fisherman's Wharf, they returned to the hotel. At a little after 10 p.m., Al Jolson, the world's greatest entertainer, left the world he had entertained for so long, after suffering a massive heart attack.
After you've gone, there's no denying you'll feel blue, you'll feel sad, you'll miss the bestest pal you've ever had. There'll come a time, now don't forget it, there'll come a time when you'll regret it. Someday, when you grow lonely, your heart'll break like mine, and you want me only. After you've gone away.
The Life and Times of Al Jolson was written, produced and narrated by Alex Hehr for Lanair Enterprises.
You feel blue, you feel sad,
you miss the best pal you've ever had.
There'll come and you'll regret it someday. When you grow lonely, your heart will break like mine, and you'll want me only after you've gone.
After you've gone and left me crying, after you've gone, there's no denying, you'll feel blue, you'll feel sad, you'll miss the best pal you've ever had. There'll come a time, now don't forget it, there'll come a time when you'll regret it. Someday, when you grow lonely, your heart'll break like mine and you want me only. After you've gone away, way, way, way,
hey!
After you've gone away.
Well, there you are. Hope you enjoyed the little tribute there to Al Jolson, tomorrow being 45 years since he departed the mortal coil. Next week, our 10 o'clock special, I'll tell you about very shortly. Here's news of next week's 10 o'clock special. Next week in the 10 o'clock special, we continue our journey looking at the Hollywood Movie Musical. Yes, program number 11 in the series, If I Had a Talking Picture. Next week at 10. This is Alex Hehr inviting you to join me for the 10 o'clock special on Thanks for the Memory from 88.3 Southern FM.
I've got a problem I don't like talking about.
Oh, you could write it down.
Yeah, that's the problem.
What's the problem?
Writing.
Writing?
And reading.
Oh, you can't read and write. But that's awful.
Well, it's not my fault.
Oh, of course it's not your fault. But it's never too late to learn.
For free private help with reading and writing, phone the free call Reading Writing Hotline on 1-800-02-1184. 1-800-02-1184.
Go on, call them. You can do it.
Has anybody here seen Kelly? K-E-L-L-Y. Has anybody here seen Kelly? Have you seen him smile? Sure his hair is red, his eyes are blue, and he's Irish through and through. Has anybody here seen Kelly? Kelly from the Emerald Isle.
Southern FM 88.3.
little you. Honey bunny boo, how do you do? Toodaloo means go away. Honey bunny boo, say that you will stay. I love you so, want you to know that if you go, it would be an awful blow. Coochie coochie coo, how I love you. Honey bunny boo means I really do.
This is Steve Price, and you're listening to Thanks for the Memory on 88.3 Southern FM with Alex Hehr.
My buddies all tell me selectees are expected by ladies to necktees. I could talk about love and why not? But believe me, it wouldn't be so hot. So let's talk of Lamar, that Hetty so fair. Why does she let Joan Bennett wear all her old hair? If you know Garbo, then tell me this news. Is it a fact the Navy's launched all her old shoes? Let's check on the veracity of Barrymore's vivacity, and why is drink capacity she gets so much publicity? Let's even have a huddle over Harvard University. But let's not talk about love. Let's wish him good luck. Let's wish him more power. That Fiorella fella, my favorite flower. Let's get some champagne from over the seas and drink to Sammy Goldwyn. Include me out, please. Let's write a tune that's playable, a ditty swing and swayable. Let's say whatever sayable about the Tower of Babel. Let's cheer for the career of Itty Bitty Betty Grayable. But let's not talk about love. Let's talk about drugs. Let's talk about dope. Let's try to picture Paramount minus Bob Hope. Let's start a new dance, let's try a new step, or investigate the cause of Mrs. Roosevelt's pep. Why not discuss, my dearie, the life of Wallace Beery, or bring a Jeroboam on and write a drunken poem on astrology, mythology, geology, philology, pathology, psychology, electrophysiology, spermology, phrenology. I owe you an apology, but let's not talk about... Oh, in case you play cards, I have some right here. So how about a game of gin rummy, my dear? Or if you feel warm and bathing's your whim, let's get in the yacht together and enjoy a short swim. But honey, I suspect you all of being intellectual, and so instead of gushing on, let's have a big discussion on timidity, stupidity, solidity, frigidity, avidity, turbidity, Manhattan acidity, fatality, morality, legality, finality, neutrality, reality, or southern hospitality, pomposity, verbosity. I'm losing my velocity, but let's not talk about love.
Danny Kaye, and from... an album released in 1957, the Cole Porter song from 1941, Let's Not Talk About Love, an interesting arrangement of said song. Before that, Van Alexander and his orchestra with Honey Bunny Boo, and opening that music break, has anybody here seen Kelly? And I've Got Rings on My Fingers. Bigotta. And Declan Foley rang in before, and that's very nice to hear from you, Declan. He has a program every Monday night here called Celtic Mix.
Cade Mila Falls listeners, my name is Declan Foley, and I have the pleasure of hosting Celtic Mix on Southern FM every Monday night from 8 to 9 p.m. I invite you to listen in and hear the great sounds of Ireland, Scotland and Wales, with a touch of poetry and the latest news hot off the press from Ireland. Join me this Monday from 8 to 9 p.m. on the great sounds from Southern FM 88.3.
Good morning, good morning.
Assure yourself of a good morning every Monday right here on 88.3 Southern FM with Bob Horsfall and Robin Collins.
Of course, the lady with the words is Audrey Hepburn.
Mm.
And she's lovely, of course, in this particular thing, as always. And
she's dead.
You never know what you're likely to hear on their Monday magazine program.
When he sees me, he rolls over so I can rub his tummy.
I often do that, but you just ignore me.
Nobody rubs.
Or is it the Rob and Bob show? No one seems to know, but no one seems to care.
He and I were drifting around the garden. He likes to be carried about a lot.
And I do just... too.
It really doesn't matter. You'll be thoroughly entertained by these two very talented people. So join them every Monday on 88.3 Southern FM between 9 and 11 a.m.
Yes, we call it Rob. No, Bob and Rob, is it? What do you call it?
I call it Rob and Bob. You call it Bob and Rob.
Oh, whatever you like.
Yes, great show. Every Monday here on 88.3 Southern FM between 9 and 11. It's 18 and a half to 11. At 11 o'clock, Comedy Tonight from Jack Buchanan and Co. Until midnight, you're on Thanks for the Memory from Southern FM 88.3.
I look at you, I love you more. To see your eyes, your smile so sweet and tender. What can I do but tell you I surrender? You never look so perfectly divine. It's almost like a dream to think you're mine. You're everything lovely, everything that I adore, and you never looked so beautiful before. Thank you.
The Great Southern Sounds of Melbourne, 88.3 Southern FM.
Plus that you couldn't be smarter. Plus that intelligent face. You have a disgraceful charm for me. You couldn't be keener. You look so fresh from the cleaner. You are the little grand slam I'll bring to my family. My ma will show you an album of me that'll bore you to tears. And you'll attract all the relatives we have dodged for years and years. And what'll they tell me? Exactly what'll they tell me? They'll say you couldn't be nicer, couldn't be sweeter, couldn't be better, couldn't be smoother, couldn't be cuter, baby, than you are.
We heard a couple of lovely songs then, didn't we? You Couldn't Be Cuter, Ruby Newman and his orchestra. Song written in 1938, and that recording from about the same year, and the vocalist was Ray Morton. And before that, Jimmy Dorsey's orchestra with Bob Eberly on vocals, and You Never Looked So Beautiful. It's 12 minutes to 11, and I'm not reading many CSAs tonight because I want to try and conserve this voice, because I've got to get through until midnight when the Candyman will be here with his program through until 2. And it's not getting any better, let's put it that way. Shall we? Why not?
In the hot seat this week, yes, Southern FM's very own Louise McMahon. Louise joining me, Steve Jenkinson, to chat about her top five. Five songs and those little stories in the past that go along with them. We're going to have a ball. Hope you can join us this Saturday between 12 and 3. Only on the station, that sounds great to me. Southern FM 88.3.
That'll be interesting, won't it? Lou in the hot seat. Goodness, 11 to 11. Until midnight, you're with Thanks for the Memory with Alex Hehr on the Great Southern Sounds of Melbourne, Southern FM 88.3. All right, Mum and Dad, time to get up and get those dancing shoes on again for the military two-step. This is the Sydney Thompson Old Time Dance Orchestra, and this collection of tunes under the title of Old Timers on Parade. Here we go.
Old Timers on Parade.
nothing but moon love. Will you be gone when the dawn comes stealing through? Are these just moon dreams, grand while the moon beams? But when the moon fades away, will my dreams come true? Much as I love you, don't let me love you. If I must pay for your kiss with lonely tears, say it's not moon love, tell me it's true love. Say you'll be mine when the moon disappears.
As a phone user, you now have access to the Telecommunications Industry Ombudsman, an independent office established to help settle any unresolved complaints or disputes you may have with your telephone company. The Telecommunications Ombudsman is a last resort free service for those telephone complaints that seem unsolvable. If you have a complaint, you can call the Ombudsman's office toll-free on 1-800-062-058. That's 1-800-062-058. An industry ombudsman for phone users.
I'm sorry as I can be, ain't you got no sympathy? Oh baby, woe is me. You were right and I was wrong. I keep singing the whole day long in a mournful minor key. Oh, woe is me. Every night the sky is moonless, every day is a dismal day. Every song I hear is tuneless. Please forgive and let me live again. Woe is me. Now I know I was crazy to let you go. Love you got me up a tree. Oh, woe is me, yeah.
That was Woe Is Me there from the Billy Cotton and his Cotton Pickers. Moon Love was played by Paul Whiteman's orchestra with the vocal by John Edwards. And opening up the music break, we heard Old Timers on Parade, Sydney Thompson's dance orchestra. It's 2 minutes to 11, and we'll squeeze this one in before we have our comedy break. I was talking to Jan Simca earlier in the evening about seeing a film on TV just recently. It was on very late at night, so it was recorded, of course, called I'll See You in My Dreams. It was the biopic of the lyricist Gus Kahn. Some wonderful music in it. Danny Thomas and Doris Day played the principal roles. Here's the song that he wrote the words for, I'll See You in My Dreams, in 1924, Gus Kahn. This is played by the orchestra of Jan Garber, just an instrumental on this particular occasion. Hope you enjoy it. I'll See You in My Dreams.